second type of product. This is called vector or cross product. So when product of two vectors is a vector quantity, again the product is said to be vector product. I repeat, when the product of two vector quantities is a vector quantity again, then the product of the vectors is termed as vector product. Like dot product, vector product is represented by cross sign. That's why it is also termed as cross product. And magnitude of cross product is a mod of b sine theta. This shows magnitude. Since product is a vector, so we put n cap also. N cap gives direction. This gives direction. Fine. So finally you can say there is a vector C, which is obtained after taking cross product of vector A and B. Case 1, when theta is equal to 0, sine 0 is 1, so the cross product of two vectors will be 0. This property you can utilize for proving that vector A and B are parallel. So if you want to prove that vector A is parallel to vector B, find out cross product, and if cross product comes out to be 0, then it is right. However, for proving that two vectors are perpendicular to each other, the right product is dot product that you have seen earlier. Case 2, when theta is equal to 90 degree, the value of sine 90 is maximum, that is 1. So the cross product of two vectors will have maximum value, that is mod of A into mod of B. Now question arises, since vector C is a vector which is obtained after taking cross product of two vectors, how do I find the direction of vector C? So the right to C method is, or easiest method is, to find out the direction of cross product of vector A and B, use right hand thumb rule. So keep your right hand ready. What you have to do, of your right hand, stretch your fingers and thumb at right angles to each other. Keep fingers parallel to the first vector in the product. Say for example, if I want to find A cross B, so keep your fingers parallel to the vector A. And then start curling your finger towards vector B. If you can curl your finger towards vector B, then whatever is the direction of your thumb, that will be the direction of resultant product vector C. So if you look at A cross B in this situation, these fingers are kept parallel to A. Now I am curling my fingers easily towards vector B. So thumb gives the direction of vector C. So it is normal, that is perpendicular to plane, outward. If you want to get A B cross A, procedure is same. Now keep your fingers parallel to B. and start curling towards vector A. So your thumb direction is inward to the plane of whiteboard. So vector C will be in opposite direction. It means opposite direction, but magnitudes are same. So you can say there is case 3, you can say there is anti commutative property. Anti commutative property. They follow anti commutative property. What is that? A cross B is equal to minus B cross A. Now, if somebody says, sir, you kept the fingers like this, you can keep fingers parallel to vector A like this. Now try to curl your finger towards vector B. Can you? You can't. So two things you have to remember. Keep your fingers of the right hand parallel to vector, first vector of the product, and then curl your finger towards another second vector of the product. Second distributive property, that is case 4, is still working. Case 4, distributive property, that it holds good, that is A cross addition B plus C. So you will get answer A cross B plus A cross C. That's how you will do. What are the quantities in physics where we use cross product? There are so many quantities, like calculating angular momentum, L is equal to R cross P, torque or moment of force, torque is equal to R cross F. Now remember, you cannot write this formula as F cross R, because if you write F cross R, you will get torque vector as in opposite direction. And another, you can say linear speed V is equal to R cross omega, where omega is angular speed of an object or particle whatsoever is moving. Now I will let you know how to calculate the product, cross product, if vectors are, or rectangle vectors are given in form of rectangular components. So let's see how to do it. Suppose two vectors are given, say vector A is equal to AX I cap, AY J cap, AZ K cap, and vector B is equal to BX I cap, BY J cap plus BZ K cap. I advise you to follow determinant method, that will be more easier. So A cross B, make a determinant of order 3 by 3, 3 rows, 3 columns. First row will be of unit vectors. Second row will be of coefficients of I cap, J cap and K cap of the first vector, whichever is the first. If you are taking A cross B, so A is the first vector. So coefficients of I cap is AX, AY, AZ, and then coefficient of B, BX, BY, BZ. Now break down this determinant in the order of the order of 2 by 2. How will you do it? Understand it easily. right I cap, block this column and row of I cap. Whatever is left, keep it together. Whatever is left, see. What is left? A by AZ, B by BZ. This is BZ. So write it down here. A by AZ, B by BZ. Now write J cap minus J cap and block this column of J cap and row, corresponding row. Block this. So what is left? AX, AZ, BX, BZ. What is left? AX, AZ, BX, BZ. Now plus K cap and block corresponding column and row of K cap. So what is left? AX, AY, BX, BY. Fine. So now you have a determinant of the order of 2 by 2. How to go about it? Multiply this, cross multiply, and minus this product. So first is this, second is this. So I AY BZ minus AZ BY minus J cap. Then first is this AX BZ minus BX AZ plus K cap. First is this AX BY minus AY BX. So that's how you got finally a vector product. And you see the resultant of A cross B, you are obtaining again a vector quantity. So let's do quickly two, three questions. Question number one, determine unit vector, perpendicular to both, both means vector A is equal to 2i cap plus j cap plus k cap, and vector B is equal to I cap minus j cap plus 2k cap. Right? I again advise you to go by this method. However, you can direct multiply and solve like dot product also, but again you have to use identity in that. I will let you know after the solution of this question what is the identity. Or I can tell you the identity here right now, no problem. See, for cross product, I cross J is equal to K, J cross K is equal to I, and K cross I is equal to J. But if you reverse the order, I mean to say J cross I, this will be minus K. K cross J minus I. I cross K minus J. But I dot I, J dot J, K dot K is 0. So you can follow that method also by multiplying, then you will obtain 9 terms, and then use this identity, cross product identity, solve it. But I think that is a lengthier. It is up to you. Determine unit vector. So first find out vector, but coming back to this question, first find out a vector which is perpendicular to both. Both means you have to find out A cross B using determinant straight, I cap, J cap, K cap, 2, 1, 1, coefficients are 1, minus 1, 2, I cap, that is 2 plus 1, minus j cap, 4 minus 1, plus k cap, minus 2, minus 1, right? So what are you getting? 3 I cap, minus 3 j cap, minus 3 k cap. This is the resultant vector C, which will be perpendicular to vector A as well as vector B. Now you have to find unit vector of vector C. Unit vector C cap is vector C over mod of C, that is 3 I cap minus 3 j cap minus 3 k cap divided by square root of 3 square minus 3 square minus 3 square, that is 3 I cap minus j cap k cap divided by 3 root 3. So this cancels, right? So what is the answer? I cap minus j cap plus k cap divided by root 3. That's how you can easily find out dot product, cross product, sorry. Let's see one more question. Quickly. This question says find A dot B if question 2, find A dot B if mod of A is equal to 3, mod of B is equal to 2, and A cross B is equal to 8. Right? So A mod of A cross B, you can say mod of A mod of B sine theta. So if you square both sides, this, right hand side you can alter little. You can put it as minus cos square theta. That is mod of A square, mod of B square, minus mod of A square, minus mod of B square, cos theta. Cos square theta. Correct? This is what? A dot B. So mod of A cross B whole square, mod of A square, mod of B square, that is A dot B whole square. Now put the value. It is 64, 9, 4, A dot B whole square. So A dot B whole square is 64 minus 36. How much it is? A dot B whole square. How much it is? 28. So A dot B is root 28. And you have got this question, and you can do a question like this. Let's see one more question quickly. This question goes like this. If A and B are two such vectors that A is equal to B. Question 3. If A, vector A and vector B are such vectors that mod of A is equal to 2 and mod of B is equal to 7 and A cross B is equal to 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 6k cap. Find angle between A and B. Fine, so let's do mod of A solution. A cross B is equal to 3 square, 2 square, 6 square, square root of this. Right? How much it comes out? Square root 49, that is 7. Using cross product formula, that is A cross B is equal to mod of A mod of B sin theta. Its magnitude is how much? 7. 7 into 2 sin theta. 7 cancels. Sin theta is equal to 1 by 2. So theta is equal to 30 degree or pi by 6. Right? That's how question 3 you